Hello, I am Rachel Clark, the Programme Manager for the Doherty Programme. Thank you for joining this Doherty webinar for applicants for Call 2. You're very welcome. This webinar will be recorded and recording will be made available on the IRC and Doherty.ie website following the webinar. Please leave any queries in the Q&A box and many thanks for registering. Okay, so the webinar structure will be, we'll give an introduction to the Doherty programme and we'll show you the structure of the fellowship, the benefits for fellows, eligibility criteria, guiding applicants through the application process, evaluation process and key dates. So the Doherty co-fund will open on the 1st of March 2023 and close 4 p.m. 21st of June 2023. So what is a Doherty Fellowship? So the goal of the MSCA Individual Fellowships, IF, is to enhance the creative and innovative potential of experienced researchers who are seeking to diversify their individual competences in terms of skill acquisition through advanced training, international and intersectoral mobility. Three Irish funding agencies have come together to create a new interdisciplinary fellowship programme on the topic of public health crises and their legacies. The complementary expertise of the three agencies, namely pan-disciplinary research, the Irish Research Council, health perspectives, Health Research Board and Environmental Policies, Environmental Protection Agency, has been crucial in defining Doherty's scope and ambitions. The lead agency, the Irish Research Council, supported by the other two co-funding agencies, the Health Research Board and the Environmental Protection Agency, will manage the programme. So Doherty Co-Fund is a prestigious award and will recruit and train 25 outstanding researchers from a variety of disciplines who will shed light on public health crises from wide-ranging perspectives. So fellows will be recruited for 36 months by an Irish higher education institute or research performing organisation. Fellows will be hosted in the first 18 months, known as the outgoing phase, in a HAEI or RPO outside of Ireland. And in the following 18 months, fellows will be hosted in a HAEI RPO in Ireland. So Doherty aims to recruit top-class researchers from anywhere in the world, funding their projects on the basis of excellence. So the benefits of the Doherty Research Programme, fellows will be provided with a 36-month fully paid internationally recognised H2020 MSCA co-fund fellowship and be employed by a main host organisation based in Ireland. Fellowships will include a family allowance where applicable, and fellows will also be free to choose their own topic, the main host organisation in Ireland, their outgoing phase host organisation, their non-academic secondment host where applicable, and their supervisors. The fellows can come from any discipline, provided their project is highly relevant to public health crises. Fellows will also deepen their disciplinary expertise while developing their interdisciplinary competencies through immersion in individual and programme-wide training opportunities. Fellows will avail of enhanced intersectoral upskilling, growing their professional networks as a result of substantial targeted exposure to policymakers and practitioners in the context of Doherty Co-Fund training events, conferences, non-academic secondments, and high-profile circulation of programme reports. Fellows will also develop partnerships, research and support networks with their co-fellows through collaboration opportunities during the fellowship. Fellows will also develop public profiles as experts in their scientific areas and beyond, supporting their future career prospects. So Doherty aims to create a critical mass of well-networked experts from all disciplinary areas and fully engaged in the Irish and EU innovation ecosystem to tackle public health crises. It also aims to promote the dissemination and communication of impactful research beyond traditional academic channels, targeting policymakers and population at large. with the objective of contributing to resourceful and resilient societies. Doherty will also pioneer an innovative multidisciplinary approach to the way public health crises are understood and tackled, with solutions emerging from cooperation between disciplines, sectors, and research areas. Doherty Fellows and alumni will contribute to relevant UN Sustainable Development Goals in relation to public health. So, for example, the SDG 3, which is good health and well-being, SDG 4, quality education, and SDG 10, reduced inequalities. So what is public health crisis and why do we need Doherty? Well, the COVID-19 pandemic highlighted the critical role of dissemination and implementation science in facilitating the rapid and effective uptake of evidence-based interventions during urgent or emerging public health events. According to the World Health Organization, challenges to public health include economic crises, inequalities, aging populations, increasing levels of chronic disease, migration and urbanization, and environmental damage and climate change. In addition to the challenges posed by the spread of infectious diseases, environmentally driven public health crises are increasingly a concern in our societies. For example, respiratory illnesses caused by particulates in the air we breathe. So some of the key points: all disciplines are welcome across the sciences, engineering, arts, and humanities, provided that the proposed research project relates to public health crises. So you can see a list there of research areas, but they're not limited to. The proposal must demonstrate how the proposed research relates to public health crises, and public health crises are not the same as public health. You can also refer to the guide for applicants for further clarification on public health crises and its definitions. So the basic structure of Doherty, as displayed, shows all three funders, the IRC, EPA, and HRB. The three funding agencies who have come together to create this new program on the topic of public health crisis will recruit fellows for 36 months, and they'll be hosted in the first 18 months, known as the outgoing phase, in a HEI abroad, and the following 18 months in the main HEI, known as the return phase. The training Doherty's training program will benefit fellows through extensive training opportunities provided by their outgoing and return HEIs and from program-wide training. Doherty's training program includes individualized training at local level in the host HEIs, as well as program-wide training. Individual training will take part in your own HEI, the partner host, and during the non-academic secondment, where applicable. Fellows will work with their supervisors in each setting to identify their training needs, identify local training opportunities to meet those needs, and to gain access to that training. The program-wide training will consist of four training events and a final conference delivered by international experts in a variety of areas related to or necessary for multifaceted research into public health crises. So the fellows will be provided with a salary composed of a living allowance and a mobility allowance, and if appropriate, a family allowance. The fellows' allowances will total to 44,026 euro without family allowance and 49,429 with the family allowance annually. Paid maternity leave is also included in line with Irish policy. All fellows will be covered by standard Irish employees' rights and entitlements, regulating, for instance, maternity, paternity leave, health coverage, pension scheme, safety and equal treatment in the workplace, as per the most recent employment legislation. There's also the Doherty program will cover training and research expenses, including non-academic secondment costs, if applicable, which amount to 8,400 per year per fellow for a total of 25,200 over the 3 years. Applicants are required to outline in their application how they plan to use this allowance for the implementation of their fellowship. International expert evaluators will be instructed to consider the appropriateness of the proposed budget to the fellowship proposal. So to be eligible to apply for the Doherty Fellowship, the applicant must be an experienced researcher. The definition of an experienced researcher in the H2020 MSCA program will be applied. Experienced researchers must, at the time of the call deadline, be in possession of a doctoral degree or have at least 4 years of full-time equivalent experience, research experience. Following the MSCA IF Global Fellowship model, all Doherty projects start with an outcome phase in an institution outside of Ireland. Fellows must relocate to the country of their proposed outgoing phase, integrating themselves in the outgoing phase host team in the partner HEI. If the outgoing phase is to a country other than a member state, MS, or associated country, AC, the applicant must be a national or long-term resident of an MS or AC. If the outgoing phase is to an MS or AC, the applicant can be of any nationality. Just to note there, the UK is included under H2020 regulations. And permanent employees of an eligible HEI cannot apply to Doherty, listing their employer as the Irish host organisation. Also, applicants must be fluent in English, in written and spoken. So once you have ensured you satisfy the eligibility criteria, there are several steps to take ahead of beginning your application for a Doherty Fellowship. First thing is to identify a suitable fellowship topic. Confirm support from your proposed main academic supervisor. Confirm support of your proposed main partner organization for the outgoing phase. You can also contact the research office in your proposed Irish host, where they can help assist you in identifying a suitable academic supervisor. Confirm a potential non-academic secondment and then apply through Smart Simple. So applicants can choose their Irish host HEI from a list of eligible HEIs or POs available on the IRC and Doherty websites. And applicants are also encouraged to include a non-academic secondment between 3 and 6 months in their project. And this can happen at any stage of their fellowship. So each fellow will have a supervisory panel consisting of their main supervisor, their outgoing supervisor, a secondment supervisor if relevant, and a mentor chosen by the fellow after commencing the fellowship. Supervisory panels will support the Doherty fellows in identifying training needs and consequently in drafting their career development plan in the early stages of their fellowship and in revising it throughout the fellowship. The application process, the entire application process is online via a web-based online application system called Smart Simple. The Irish Research Council encourages the submission of applications well in advance of the closing date for the competition, as on the day that the call closes, there will be heavy traffic on the server, which may slow down the submission of your application. To prevent problems with heavy server traffic, do not wait until the final day of the call to submit your application. So the applicant completes their application form on the online system. The main Irish supervisor submits their statement of commitment form on the OLS prior to the call deadline. The outgoing supervisor provides a letter of commitment to the applicant, which the applicant will upload as part of their application form. And as it says there, it's essential that the participants nominated in the application, the main supervisor, will be available to complete their respective form prior to the applicable deadline. Submission of the form is an integral part of the fully completed application, and failure to submit these forms by the call deadline will result in the application being deemed ineligible. So there is a week, supervisor will need to complete their section of the form within 1 week of the deadline for applicants. And then research offices will do it another week after that. So important note regarding application deadline, the call will close automatically at 4 p.m. On the 21st of June. And applications not received by the OLS by this deadline will be ineligible. And it's strictly enforced, the deadline. So Smart Simple, as I say, is the application that we use. Applicants who have previously applied to IRC or IRC set schemes do not need to register with the online application system. When you log in, you will be presented with a home screen, which will be similar to the screen snapshot on displayed on screen. The online system allows you to update your profile, apply for funding under an open call, and access your submitted applications. So key parts of the application form include applicant details, academic qualifications, fellowship proposal, relevant work experience, publications and other research outputs, professional achievements, ethical and sex gender dimension statements, indicative budget, applicant declarations, and personal statement. So the within the application, the criterion, excellence, impact, and implementation are the important sections. In excellence, you need to describe how the project relates to public health crises, research outline methodologies, interdisciplinary aspects. Applicants should also refer to the benefits of the program-wide training. Impact, research, novelty, and impact, how being involved in Doherty Co-Fund will impact on your career. And then implementation, a work plan, risk management. You will need to upload a Gantt chart using a template detailing milestones, deliverables, and dissemination. So a guide to completing your application will be available soon on the Doherty website. So sex, gender dimension in research. An initiative arising from the Council's gender strategy is a requirement for all applicants to demonstrate that they have given full consideration to whether there is a potential sex or gender dimension in their proposed research. Applicants should consult the call documentation for further information. As gender considerations are extremely likely to be relevant to a wide number of individual projects at application stage, applicants will be asked to elaborate on gender aspects of their proposal. One of the planned training events for Doherty will be dedicated to gender training. An ethics statement will also be required to complete. You can complete an ethics self-assessment online as part of your application, which will follow current H2020 guidelines and will be assessed during the evaluation process. Where ethical issues may arise in the research, applicants are required to submit to the IRC a written statement that full consideration has been given to the ethical implication of the research proposal. And then full ethical approval from the relevant HEI or PO ethics committee is not required at the application stage. However, if the application is successful, evidence of full ethical approval will be required before activities for which ethical approval is needed commence, but no later than 3 months after the start date of the fellowship. And it is the applicant's responsibility to identify any potential ethics issues, to handle the ethics aspects of the proposal, and to detail how they plan to address them. This will be part of the assessment criteria used to evaluate the proposals and in the monitoring of funded projects. So the process is when you fill out complete the ethics self-assessment, there will be a preliminary ethics committee who will review those ethical statements and will flag any ethical issues. So the evaluation process is a two-step process consisting of initial remote peer review, followed by panel interview. And for those who do progress to the second step. So step one, the initial peer review. In the first step, applications will be evaluated remotely by 3 independent international expert reviewers per proposal, chosen on the basis of the keywords indicated by the applicants and their abstracts. These 3 expert assessors submit their qualitative and quantitative evaluation. The applications will then be ranked, and reviewers will score the proposals on a range from 0 to 5 with weighting applied for the different sections, excellence, impact, and implementation. And then reviewers will be asked to provide short written feedback in the form of an individual evaluation summary report. Then step 2, the interview stage. Once the remote peer review assessment process is complete, applicants will be informed of the outcome by email. Applicants who do not progress to interview stage will receive their evaluation summary report and information on the Doherty redress process. Those who do progress to interview stage will be notified and requested to prepare a presentation of their project tailored to a non-scientific audience. The researcher will be asked to specify which audience they are addressing, for example, school children, senior citizens, or members of an environmental group. All interviews will start with the researcher's 10-minute presentation. Slides will be allowed, and interviewers will follow up with pre-agreed set of questions. The IRC will send out written email communication inclusive of the individual interview report to all interviewed applicants, including the mention of whether they are offered a fellowship or not. So just to stress again, the relevance of the proposed research project to public health crisis will be assessed under each criteria. So once the call is opened, candidates will direct questions to the institutional research offices. Any questions that can't be answered, the research offices will forward them on to us. And we also regularly update the FAQ document, and they will be hosted on the IRC and Doherty web pages as displayed there. So the next steps for the applicants before the call opens, please help ensure that the potential host supervisors and departments are aware of the programme and of all the information needed. As Doherty is open to all disciplinary backgrounds, as long as the research project focuses on public health crises, researchers from across the sciences, engineering, social sciences and humanities may be interested. Applicants will need to get in touch with potential supervisors, and research officers may be able to assist with this. So also guidance for applicants and all further details are on the Doherty.ie website, and preparing to apply hints and tips are also there on the website. Doherty@research.ie is our email address, and Doherty.ie is the website address. So the key dates, the call two opens the 1st of March, applicant deadline is 4 p.m. Irish time, 21st of June. Supervisor deadline, 4 p.m. Irish time, 28th of June, 2023. And a research office deadline, 4 p.m. Irish time, 5th of July, 2023. So at this stage, I just want to thank you for listening, and the very best of luck of your application. And please do not hesitate to contact us on Doherty@research.ie. Thank you very much.